Yeah, those angels of mercy used to sing and beg down in Pershing Square, L.A. Voices that haunted me and still do. Lost nightmare Jesus sounds coming out of the coins rattling in a cup from two blind ladies.
Honesty is a great commodity, but we're not living in a society or an artistic culture where there is any honesty.
I was born in the City of Angels in the late 1940s, down on Hope Street, near Pershing Square and Clifton's Cafeteria and the Pantry, and all them old strip joints on 5th and Main. You know, tonight, White Fury and her twin 44s, Charles Bukowski territory.
All the people I sort of admire are just individuals. This is things I've been through, and this is what I'm saying.
We play a lot of venues all over the world, all different sizes, cafes, listening rooms, the Borderline in London, Joe's Pub in New York City. But the most interesting one recently has been a train across Canada from Vancouver, where I started my career, to Toronto. And last year we did it with Hot Club of Cowtown, Fats Kaplan, Christy Rose. And every night on the train we performed, every day we did workshops while this wonderful atmosphere was going by.
It's like an epic journey, and I think a train gives you that kind of feel.
Good to be here, and we've got lots of train people here tonight. We're welcoming all the train people. How you doing out there? We got all 70 of them. We're gonna do you a sort of a train song about a guy taking a train back to Lyon, France. Train people from Lyon out there in the audience. I wrote this with Steve Young. It's about a guy going back to Lyon in search of a girlfriend that's rediscovered her spirituality for the 20th time. He had a vision of Anne Marie with a rosary in her hand. And so it's exit the rainmaker, Lord the gray flannel man, with a closet full of business suits. He left a letter near the phone. It said, I'm on my way to paradise to see the angel of Lyon. And then he called the train to Brussels. He ordered cognac and croissants. He made a mental list of things he owned and didn't want. All the buildings, all the real estate, the antique glass and stone. He traded a vow of poverty to see his angel of Lyon. And he sang Ave Maria, or at least the parts he knew, and watched the shadow of the train on the towns that they rolled through. And he closed his eyes and saw two rivers, the Rhone and the Saône, the male and female spirit of that city of Lyon. Then he waited near the bridge where they'd met the year before. But the days turned into weeks, and then the seasons numbered four, and his clothes grew worn and ragged. It's through that town he roamed, searching every open window for his angel of Lyon. And he sang Ave Maria, or at least the parts he knew, and watched his shadow on the wall of the streets that he crawled through.
And he crossed those holy rivers, yeah, the Rhone and the Saone. They'd not give up the secret of the Angel of Lyon. There's a thousand.
Andrew Hardin.
Candles burning in the basilica tonight, where Sister Eve Maria is the keeper of the light. And down a dream of alleyways walks the saint of rainbow, a madman torn asunder by the Angel of Lyon. And he sang Ave Maria, or at least the parts he knew, and watched his shadow on the wall of the streets that he crawled through. And he crossed those holy rivers, hear the Rhone and the Saone. They'd not give up the secret of the Angel of Lyon.
Andrew Hardin from Wimberley, Texas.
I always think of this next song when I think of Vancouver, and I did spend, seems like half my life in those bars on East Hastings Street.
I was born back in the Southland, down in Texas.
I was
Texas.
Down there two nights ago, and
I was never supposed to know.
Didn't see a lot of old friends still alive, but I saw a new crop. And
hey, Tom, we love you, baby.
It always meant a lot to me. I was an enumerator first and went through a lot of those old hotels talking to men. And then I ended up playing eight sets a night in the golf club, learning the trade.
The golf club sat there, big sleazy club with a neon sign that said country rock music 8 hours a day. So we went to work at 6 p.m. and worked till 2 in the morning. We'd play eight sets in this joint, and basically backing up female impersonators, sword swallowers, topless dancers, and snake acts. But it was a wonderful place, and a tragic place. And at the same time, I had a daughter, Jessica, and a wife I was supporting, and just trying to scuffle by and learn how to become a songwriter.
This one's called Blue Wing. He had a blue wing tattooed on his shoulder. Well, it might have been a bluebird, I don't know. But he gets stone drunk, talk about Alaska, the salmon boats 45 below. He said he got that blue wing up in Walla Walla, where his cellmate there was a little Willie John. Willie, he was once a great blues singer, and Wingin' Willie wrote him
of song. They said it's dark in here, can't see the sky, but I look at this blue wing and I close my eyes, then I fly away beyond these walls, up above the clouds, where the rain don't fall on a poor man. They paroled Blue Wing in August 1963. He moved north picking apples to the town of Wenatchee. And then winter finally caught him in a rundown trailer park on the south side of Seattle, where the days grow gray and dark. And he drank and he dreamt a vision when the salmon still ran free, and his father's fathers crossed that wild old Bering Sea. And the land belonged to everyone, and there were old songs yet to sing. And now it's narrowed down to a cheap hotel and a tattooed prison wing. Hey, it's dark in here, can't see the sky, but I look at this blue wing and I close my eyes, and then I fly away these walls, up above the clouds, where the rain don't fall on a poor man's dream. Well, he drank his way to LA, that's where he died. But no one knew his Christian name, and there was no one there to cry. But I dreamt there was a funeral, preacher at an old pine box. Halfway through the sermon, old Blue Wing began to talk. He said, it's dark in here, can't see the sky, but I look at this blue wing and I close my eyes, then I fly away beyond these walls, up above the clouds, where the rain don't fall on a poor man's dream. Yeah, yeah. On a poor man's dream. Yeah, yeah, yeah. On a poor man's dream.
Tom took this music train thing and ran with it, and it was just perfect for Tom. You know, for him to handpick the musicians and pick the format, and, you know, trains are romantic, trains are country music, you know, airplanes aren't country, you know, cars aren't country.
It harkens back to the old days when trains were really neat. The second thing is it's on one of the most historic train routes and beautiful train routes in the world, of the CN line from Vancouver to Toronto, going up through the Rockies, heading towards Edmonton, and stopping up in Jasper there. And then as you come out of the Rockies down into the prairies, and there's nothing between Vancouver and Toronto really, but the West as it's always been. And that appealed to me. And then to put a little folk festival aboard a train, I thought was unique.
Look at the beauty of the landscape here. I mean, I'm looking out at a frozen lake, you know. And the train thing, I love trains, I hate cars, I hate planes, so, but it's a good time. It's, you know, train in the tunnel, you know, it's great.
Well, I led out to southern Arizona, I followed an abandoned railroad track, chains he used to run from Bisbee out to Juarez, but the copper mines are closed. Trains ain't coming back. This here's a land of stolen ponies, rattlesnakes and poison water well. Each got forsaken mile, he's right to heaven, just trying to please that woman, it was hell. Let's go. Put me on the next thing smoking. Yeah, put me on the next train out of here. This heart ain't made for being broken. She ain't my conductor and she ain't my engineer. Put me on the next thing, leaving you. The northern or the southern hemisphere. Yeah, put me on the next thing, smoking. Great God, put me on the next train out of here. I'm bound to ride. I've got my pride. I'm bound to ride. I'm bound to ride. To the ghost town of Hachita. I got drunk in the Hachita General Store. I passed the place Geronimo surrendered. Well, Geronimo and me, we just can't cut it anymore. I hitchhiked from Columbus to El Paso, where I can get you an Amtrak or free. I walked 300 miles across the Badlands. Yeah, brother, I have made my great escape. Put me on the next thing smoking. Yeah, put me on the next train out of here. This heart ain't made for being broken. She ain't my conductor and she ain't my engineer. Put me on the next thing leaving you. The northern or the southern hemisphere. Yeah, put me on the next thing smoking. Great God, put me on the next train out of here. I'm bound to ride. I've got my pride. I'm bound to ride. I'm bound to ride.
From Wimberley, Texas.
He's a very strong accompanist in the way that he listens to the words, puts something appropriate in the right place between the words. Doesn't even have to have heard the song. We rarely rehearse, if at all.
I'm looking to exploit guitar opportunities, but not like you would think, you know, not like Stairway to Heaven or something, but just, you know, looking for, oh, this chord sounds good against that chord, or, you know, little things like that.
He was driving cab when I met him. I was driving cab just to support my wife and daughters and trying to be a novelist. But he right away, he had heard Gallo del Cielo, which I had just written, and thought, you should be playing, man.
I mean, actually, after two lines, you know, I knew that he was on to something, and I knew that I had something to contribute to it, you know, which was, you know, just playing.
This is called El Gallo del Cielo. Rooster on heaven! Señores, con corazón no comprende de eso nada porque nos hicieron bien. We don't have to play you any stinking chicken song, but we will, because we love you. Hola! Carlos Zaragoza left his home in Casas Grande when the moon was full. No money in his pocket, just a locket of his sister framed in gold. He rolled into El Sueco, stole a rooster called El Gallo del Cielo. Then he crossed the Rio Grande with that fighter nestled deep beneath his arm.
El Gallo del Cielo was a fighter born in heaven, so the legends say. His wings, they had been broken. He had one eye rolling crazy in his head. And he fought 100 fights, but the legends say that one night near El Sueco, they fought Cielo 7 times, and 7 times he left Bray Brewster's dead.
What am I to you, sir? I am thinking of you now in San Antonio.
I have $27 and the good luck of your picture framed in gold.
Tonight I'll put it all on the fighting spurs of Gallo del Cielo.
And then I'll return to buy the land that Villa stole from father long ago. Outside of San Diego, in the onion fields of Paco Monteverde, the pride of San Diego, he lay sleeping on his fancy bed of silk. But they laughed when Zaragoza pulled that one-eyed Del Cielo from beneath his coat. And they laughed when Zaragoza walked away with $1,000 bill.
Well, am I Teresa? I am thinking of you now in Santa Barbara.
I have $1,500 and the good luck of your picture framed in gold.
Tonight I'll put it on the fighting spurs of Gallo del Cielo.
And then I'll return to buy the land that Villa stole from father long ago. Now the moon has gone to hiding, lantern light spills shadows on the fighting sand, where a wicked black named Zorro faces Gallo del Cielo in the night. But Carlos Zaragoza fears the tiny crack that runs across his rooster's beak. And he fears he has lost the $50,000 riding on the fight.
What am I to you, sir? I am thinking of you now in Santa Clara.
Yes, some money's on the table. I'm holding to your good luck framed in gold. And everything we dreamed of is riding on the spurs of Del Cielo. I pray that I'll return to buy the land that Villa stole from father long ago. Then the signal that was given, roosters rose together far above the sand. El Gallo del Cielo sunk a gaff into Zorro's shiny breast. They were separated quickly, but they rose and fought each other 37 times. And the legends say that everyone agreed Del Cielo fought the best. Then the screams of Zaragoza filled the night outside the town of Santa Clara. As the beak of Del Cielo, it lay broken like a shell within his hand. And they say that Zaragoza screamed a curse upon the bones of Pancho Villa. When Zorro rose up one last time and drove Del Cielo through the sand.
What am I to you, sir? I am thinking of you now in San Francisco.
There is no money in my pocket. I no longer have your good luck framed in gold. I buried it last evening with the bones of my beloved Del Cielo. And I'll not return to buy the land that Villa stole from father long ago. Do the rivers still run muddy outside of my beloved Casas Grande? Does the scar upon my brother's face turn red when he hears mention of my name? To the people of El Sueco, curse the depth of Gallo del Cielo. Well, tell my family not to worry, I will not return to cause him shame.
For somebody like me, I could have gone to Nashville 25 years ago and written for other people. And I've had a few cuts by other people and semi-hits with Nancy Griffith, like Outbound Plane. Didn't appeal to me. I was really more interested in what I wanted to write. And like I say, the first song I wrote, one of the first songs I wrote was about cockfighting, just because the story interested me. I wasn't that into cockfighting. I was into the metaphor and the human story.
For one thing, Tom rediscovers his songs every time he sings them. He's fully present in his music. And, you know, it's one thing to be a songwriter, and it's another thing to kind of deliver your own, you know, your muse each time you perform it. And I love him as a performance artist. I think Tom is just, he's really one of the most prolific artists that I know.
Somebody said, here, you gotta listen to this guy, Tom Russell. And I was like, oh yeah, Katie Moffitt told me about Tom Russell. And I put it on, and the first song was Blue Wing, and by the end of the song, my life had changed. And I decided to go back home to California and write songs the way that I always wrote them. And so I always credit Tom with sort of helping me find my soul again. And you know, Blue Wing's just one of those songs. It's just, you know, that changed my life. I'm sure it changed Tom's when he wrote it, and I wish I had written it.
I became known those first 20 years for ballads like Blue Wing and Western songs like Navajo Rug that I wrote with Ian Tyson, and these kind of rough cog type stories about other people. And I enjoy doing that. I can do that all day. They're a little bit too journalistic for me now because I'm writing about somebody else. I always wanted to at least be truthful, whether I was writing U.S. Steel about a guy going to his last lunch in the U.S. Steel factory. I wanted it to be about him and his life and how he was going to survive. And I never ever and have never delivered a message at the end of it, of any song, except the message of that person's life.
My name is Isaac Lewis. I'm an able-bodied man. On the ship, the Royal Charter, bound off for Von Damien's land. Oh, the sea that took 6 months to cross, we could do in two. So it's up that Mersey River, boys, out of Liverpool we flew. And some of us were sailors, all hardies, young and old. And some of us were pioneers, bound off for the gold. There were merchants and musicians, Christian soldiers of the cross. We stared into that foamy sea, saw our dreams down in the broth. Sail on, sail on and on and on. For my name is Isaac Lewis, and this shall be my song. So we landed there in Botany Bay, and the boys went on the town. And I met a girl named Emma Gray, I loved her up and down. And I swore that I'd return for her one more tour of sea. But I had to tell my father what he meant to me. For every night I dreamed a dream as the wind swept through the sails, that I was in my father's house back in Northern Wales. And he reached out for my father. I said, I love you very much. But the ship rolled o'er and the dream was drowned before we got to touch. Sail on and on and on. My name is Isaac Lewis, and this shall be my song. So I kissed the lips of Emma Gray and said, sail for Liverpool. and the parrots perched in the riggins, boys, dolphins swam in schools. And our trip, it was a pleasant one, till we reached the coast of Wales. One day out from Liverpool, God unleashed the gale. Good Lord, I've seen some squalls, me boys, hurricanes at sea. And many nights I'd rediscovered faith on bended knee. But I'd never seen it blow so hard, we anchored her at last. But the waves rolled o'er the top of us, we had to cut the masts. And all the mining magnates clutched their gold, believing they'd be saved. But their bloody greed destroyed them first beneath the angry waves. All the women and the children lost to eternity. Our man has tamed and shaped the land, but he'll never tame the sea. And every night I had dreamed a dream as the wind swept through the sails, that I was in my father's house back in northern Wales. And I reached out for my father, I said, I love you very much. But the ship rolled o'er and the dream was drowned before we got to touch. Sail on and on and on. My name is Isaac Lewis, this shall be my song. We were caught upon the rocks, 10 yards from the shore. And we saw men standing on the rocks, maybe 3 or more. And I swear I saw my father waving at me through the squall. And I screamed that I was coming home, that's all that I recall. For the waves, they swept me overboard with broken masts and sails. And I drowned, whereas a child I'd fished on the rocks of northern Wales. And in 3 days' time, I washed upon the white and sandy shore. 100 yards from mole free in my father's white oak door. Sail on and on and on. My name is Isaac Lewis, this shall be. And some will cry coincidence, or say it can't be true. I only say just tell your loved ones what they mean to you. For ye may sail the sea of life, pursuing golden schemes, yet drown so closely to your home, the cradle of your dreams. Sail on and on and on. My name is Isaac Lewis, this has been my song. My name is Isaac Lewis, and this shall be my song.
Speaking of those bars really down on East Hastings, and I still feel a tug there, but a lot of you might not have known, one of my mentors and really a guy that I learned a lot from was a guy that also came out of those bars 10 years before me, and that's Ian Tyson. And of course, I was a huge Ian and Sylvia fan, and I have all their records. And I got to produce a couple Sylvia Tyson records after they'd broken up and write songs with both of them. And I know more about Ian and Sylvia than Ian does.
Oh, I don't care about that.
He went to on to cowboy music, and we've written a lot of songs. This was the first one that Ian and I co-wrote way back when I was living in New York City. The original I song, we want you to help us sing on this, Navajo Rug. Yeah. Just a little more of this guitar, please. Well, it's three eggs up on whiskey toast, home fries on the side. You wash it down with that roadhouse coffee, burns up your inside. It's just a Canyon, Colorado diner, a waitress I did love. Where we sat in the back neath the old stuffed bear in a worn-out Navajo rug. Well, old Jack, the boss, he closed at six, then it's Katie barred the door. She'd pull down that Navajo rug and spread it on the floor. Hey, I saw light in the sacred mountains, saw the dance of the turtle doves when I was lying next to Katie on that old Navajo rug. Aye, aye, aye. Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, aye, aye. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug in you? Katie, yeah. Well, I saw Jack about a year ago. He said the place burned to the ground, and all he'd saved was an old bear tooth. And Katie, she left town. Oh, but Katie, she got her a souvenir too. Jack spat out a back old plug. He said you should have seen her running through the smoke, a dragging that Navajo rug. Aye, aye, aye. Sing it out. Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, aye, aye. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug in you? Katie, shades of red and blue. So every time I cross the sacred mountains and a lightning breaks above, it always takes me back in time to my long lost Katie love. But everything keeps moving, everybody's on the go. Well, you don't find things that last anymore like a double woven Navajo. Aye, aye, aye. Come on. Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, aye, aye. Katie, whatever became of the Navajo rug in you? Katie, shades of red and blue. Faded out professionally. Whatever became of the Navajo rug? Katie, shades of red and blue.
It was never in the cards for me to be a huge commercial success, because I don't want to be pinned down in what I'm doing. I mean, I did a record called The Man from God Knows Where, which is a folk opera about where I come from, and the next one might be a cowboy record. And you can't do that and expect to be building a huge commercial career, but the great thing that's happening is my fan base keeps getting a little bigger every day by ones and twos, and that's rewarding for me. And now I make records and can even paint the covers and just hand the whole project to the record company and they put it out. So I really would not want to be in anybody else's shoes.
Thank you. What happened to the kid in the baseball cap? Well, he's trying to make it home, but I think he lost the map. What happened to the kid with the braces on his teeth? He had an autographed picture of Muhammad Ali. He's just a wise-ass, buck-toothed, nearsighted fool. He's always staring at the girls in the swimming pool. 40 years later, he's staring again, still searching for a place where the dream begins, looking for a place where the dream begins. Then he bought a bunch of records and heard a man sing, Bob Dylan. If I could write a song, I believe I'd be a king. But it took him 20 years until he got the nerve. He's got boxes full of papers, papers full of words. And the words fly away like swallows on the wind. But they never flew back to the nest again, never took him to a place where the dream begins. Yeah. Then he finally got married and they had two little girls. But he didn't see them much because he had to see the world. And the lies that it told him said, I'm like most men. It's always down the road a dream begins. And the girls grew up to be pretty and wise. They said you could have seen the dream by looking in our eyes. You were always living in a world of pretend. You keep running away from where the dream begins. Running away where the dream begins. Then he was living with a woman out on Borderland Road. But her love turned bitter and her eyes turned cold. She said, we came to the desert, let the sickness mend. Hell ain't the place where the dream begins. Look out, boy, something gaining on you. He's old Blind Joe Death in his alligator shoes. He's got a pocket full of pills and a pint of slow gin. He's gonna take you to the place where the dream begins. Follow him down to where the dream begins. Yeah. At the end of the road, there ain't nothing but fear. Just a big old room, big old mirror. And the man in the mirror's hair's turning gray. His hands begin to shake in a funny kind of way. He knows everything you bring forth will save your soul. Everything denied will condemn you to the hole. With his hand on his heart, he picks up his pen. He goes looking for the place where the dream begins, looking for a place where the dream begins. Yeah. What happened to the kid in the baseball cap? Well, he's trying to make it home, but I think he lost the map.
The first song I wrote on Skid Row back in Vancouver was called The End of the Trail. And it's inspired by this statue by Fraser.
James Fraser also did the Buffalo Nickel.
And that's the first song I wrote, Into the Trail. We're giving you the real stuff here. The real stuff. These are my real teeth.
Pancho Villa across the border. In the year of odd 16, the people of Columbus still hear him riding through their dreams. He killed 17 civilians. You could hear the women scream. Scream. Blackjack Pershing on a dancing horse was waiting in the wings. Tonight we ride. Tonight we ride. We'll skin old Pancho Villa and make shafts out of his hide. Shoot his horse, Siete Lewas, and his 27 brides. Tonight we ride, boys. Tonight we ride. We rode for 3 long years till Blackjack Pershing called it quits. When Jackie wasn't looking, I stole his fine spade bit. He was tied up on a stallion, yeah, I rode away on it. To the wild Chihuahuan desert, so dry you couldn't spit. Tonight we ride. You bastards dare. We'll hunt the wild Apache for the bounty on his hair. Then we ride into Columbus, climb up the whorehouse stairs. Tonight we ride, boys. Tonight we ride. Too damn old to sit a horse, I'm gonna steal the warden's car. Break my ass out of this prison, leave my teeth there in a jar. You don't need no teeth for kissing girls or smoking cheap cigars. I'll sleep with one eye open, neath God's celestial stars. Tonight we rock, tonight we roll. We'll rob the Juarez liquor stores for the rapists out of gold. Hey, if we drink ourselves to death, ain't that the cowboy way to go? Tonight we ride, yeah, tonight we ride. Tonight we fly, we're heading west to the deserts and the oceans where the eagle makes its nest. If our bones bleach on the desert, we'll consider we are blessed. Tonight we ride, boys, tonight we ride. Tonight we ride, boys. Tonight we ride.
Dave Alvin and I supposedly invented Americana with Tulare Dust 10 years ago.
You know, to me, everything's folk music just about.
Country was so bad, you had to have this outsider voices like Guy Clark and Dave Alvin and Tom Russell and David Olney.
It's the kind of thing, it can really get frustrating, and it can really sort of knock you off course if you worry about it.
What'd you do?
America's Most Wanted.
I'm sitting here drinking in the last bar owner, Club Zanzibar. I'm sitting here drinking in the last bar owner. But out in California, she's tearing off her tight red skirt. Well, the mountain's out the window, there's a woman lying on a bed. Lord, the mountain's here shaped like a woman lying naked on a bed. She may be out in California, I can't get her out of my head. Out in California. Well, they killed all the Indians, they shot all the grizzly bears. Yeah, out in California, they shot all the grizzly bears. But she just stands by the window and she's combing out her long black hair. Well, if a man keeps a running, he'll run right into himself. Lord, if a man keeps a moving, he'll run right into himself. She may be out in California, lying down with somebody else. Out in California.
out in California.
Get wild. On a guitar. Happy to be in Vancouver. Happy to be anywhere. We both are. Gonna buy me a shotgun soon as my luck rolls around. I'm gonna buy me a Chevy soon as my luck rolls around. Yeah, then I drive right back to that California town. Well, I'm sitting here drinking in the last bar on earth. Yeah, I'm sitting here drinking in the last bar on earth. But out in California, she's taking off her tight red skirt. Out in California. Out in California. Out in California. Hey.
The roots of the culture and the roots of the music go back through Bob Dylan to Hank Williams to Jimmy Rogers, whatever genre you're in, the blues to jazz, and they go back, in my sense, through cowboy songs to Ireland.
And so it doesn't matter whether you're a singer-songwriter with an acoustic guitar singing songs you wrote yourself, or whether you're a Chicago blues band, you're playing folk music.
Then we arrive at what your job is, a troubadour, a minstrel, singing the news to the king. Or the song's good, you get to sleep with his wife. If it's bad, you get your head cut off. That's the same job it's always been. So, but you're steeped in the American canon, which you have to look at what's gone before you, and that's what most young writers don't do.
I like pictures being painted in my head. Tom has the ability to paint very nice pictures, very vivid pictures. In some ways, it's not an appreciated type of songwriting anymore. In the age of video, the less pictures you put in people's head, the better, I guess, to sell millions of records. But for us old-fashioned guys, you know, Tom's a great songwriter.
I was walking down a quiet road in Ireland, out beneath the tough old ancient star. I thought I heard old Scottish Mike sing Carrick Fergus, and I recall the wild days in those loud Norwegian bars.
What'd he say?
He'd sing, I'm drunk today and rarely sober, just like a soldier on the road to Mandalay. All the road he gave him wine, and the women dark and fine. He drunk himself to death, I heard today. Oh, but we'll sing hallelujah, we'll sing it in the morning. Yeah, thank the Lord for giving one more day. And for the ones who passed on through, we sing this one for you. All the road it gives and the road it takes away. My baby said she didn't mind me traveling. Said she enjoyed her time alone when I was gone. And she looked me in the eye and said it's over. I saw the anger buried far too long. So I picked up my guitar and sang The Dutchman, about two people whose love grew kind with age. But my baby, she was gone before the song was sung. All the music never touched her anyway. Oh, but we'll sing hallelujah, we're singing in the morning. Yeah, thank the Lord for giving one more day. For the ones who passed on through, we'll sing this one for you. All the road it gives and the road it takes away. Hey. And for the ones who passed on through, we'll sing this one for you. All the road it gives and the road it takes away. Thank y'all. Andrew Hardin on the guitar. Thank y'all for listening. Thank you, train people. Thank you, Vancouver. Thank you, East Hastings Street. Thank you.
I rode the rods on steam trains with a banjo on my knee, while the voice of Stephen Foster, he whispered songs to me of a storefront church and a chain gang choir. Black sorrow filled the air. Then Stephen died on the Doss House floor like a man from God knows where. I heard the sound of Indian drums, I heard the bugles blow before they rewrote history into a Wild West show. My kin sailed toward America to steal their Indian ground. They passed Bill Cody